This is session 30 of my SwiftUI for iOS 15 course, and today we're going to take our custom transition to the next level by adding images, a scroll view, as well as a background material, and what kind of problems we're going to face as we do that. First of all, looking at the design here, you can see that both the background and the image is underneath the text, so we're going to do that using background modifiers. And you can see that in the full view, the texts actually have an extra container. So the challenge will be, how do we animate all of this stuff, including the background material, and how to restructure things without breaking the transition. First of all, let's change the background. Instead of a color, we're going to use image, parentheses, quotes, background, 5. Because images tend to use the original size, I'm going to have to make it resizable and also set the aspect ratio. And I only need the content mode, so I can delete the first value. And I'm going to set this to fill. Then we can essentially copy the background modifier and replace that for the end view. So the transition itself is not breaking, and it actually works quite well. Now, what about the rounded corners? What is really interesting about all of this? Just like the background, we're going to need to set each of the shapes that we're using, even though it doesn't seem like a shape for the color or for the image, it is, and we need to apply everything using match geometry effect. So it's easier to set its own modifier, which is mask, and then for the shape itself, we're going to use rounded rectangle, corner radius 30, style continuous. And this is going to allow us to set the rounded corners. We just need to set the match geometry so that it's animated. ID is going to be mask and namespace. Let's copy this the same way for the beginning state, right after the first background. And now we have the rounded corners as well. Again, you might be wondering, why do I need to set match geometry effect all the time? Well, if you don't do that, you will definitely run into problems. You can see that the masking is definitely falling back to the typical fade in, fade out transition. So that's why we need the match geometry effect to make everything seamless. Next, in the start view, we're going to add the image, which is the item in the front. So to save time, we can definitely copy the same background modifier for the background, and we can put that right before, and it's using almost exactly the same structure. So instead of background 5, it's going to be illustration 9. And for the ID, it's going to be image instead. So we're going to copy this and put that for the end view as well. So it's going to look like this, but we can change to .fit instead of .fill. As a result, the image is not going to try to fill the entire screen at the cost of stretching everything. Next, what if we have a spacer for the main view as well? So we're going to need a spacer, but when you use a spacer, it's going to try to use the maximum height, and therefore you're going to want to use a fixed frame. We're going to set the frame before the padding and set the height of 300. So it's definitely starting to look pretty good, just like in the design. Next, we're going to add a scroll view this time. So in the end view, command click on the VStack, embed, set the scroll view. Perfect. Now this is going to take the minimum size because it's scroll view. But you can see that everything is just super flexible as you make the changes to the structure, to the size, the padding, the scrolling, and all of that stuff. Because the cover is taking the minimum size, I might want to set a fixed height now. So frame height to 500. Awesome. Okay, this is fun. Let's throw in another challenge, which is we're going to add a new view. So a new container for all the text. And we're going to add even extra content here. So we're going to go to the end view. We're going to restructure the VStack here. Instead of using the text inside the VStack, we're going to use an overlay instead, because we have a floating container. We're going to move all the three text inside the overlay, but we are going to need a VStack as well here. And we're going to keep the spacer. We're also going to move the alignment and the spacing, which applies to the text and not to the container here, like this. Now, by changing the structure, it's still going to work perfectly, except that the spacer here is on the VStack, which means that it's going to take the maximum height, but not width. As a result, you're going to need to have a frame using max width to infinity. So now it's going to compensate perfectly, because remember that we have the title that has a max width, or we have the content itself, which allows this VStack content to take the max width. But since this has been moved, we need to compensate that with this frame. Next, for the end view text, we're going to need a background material. So since we have a VStack here, we can apply that right there. Let's set a background on the VStack. And inside the background, again, we want to use mass geometry effect on all of these individual shapes. So it's going to be a rectangle this time. Then I'm going to set the fill to ultra thin material. I want to have round corners, so I'm going to use mask rounded rectangle, parentheses corner radius, which is going to be 30, style continuous. Then we're going to set the match geometry effect. It's going to be called blur in the namespace. And we can move the entire container a little bit by using offset y to 100. And also we want to add some padding, so padding 20 before the background. Next, we want to make the main card a little bit more readable, so we can use a really cool technique, again using the background blur with a blur. So let me just copy this background modifier and go to the main view, and I'm going to group these three texts together inside a VStack first and apply the background on that VStack. So let me create the VStack on the first text, put the background, and then move the other two text. As a result, you might need to move your padding as well from the main VStack to the new VStack. So let's move this before the background. And also, because the alignment and the spacing applies to the text, we're going to move also the alignment on the VStack. Finally, we want to have a slightly different style, just like in the design. So we're going to add a blur modifier with a radius of 30. So that blurs the background a little bit. Of course, you can add a drop shadow to the text to make it even more readable. But you can see that the blur element itself transitions properly. Next, I'm just going to go to the end view. I'm going to fix some of the padding here, but also notice that I'm using a mask after the background, which means that it's going to clip the content. So for example, if I was to set 200 in terms of offset, the content itself is being clipped. So to fix that, I'm going to need to move the overlay after the mask, and that's very important. So as a result, you can see that I have no problem here. I can even add 50. It's going to go outside. And for the padding, this padding is useless. So I can move this padding right after the offset on the VStack inside the overlay. So now I have something that is almost exactly like what I have in the design. I might want to add some content before we finish. So on the overlay for the VStack, right after the third text, I'm going to add an HStack and put an avatar on the left and a text on the right. For the avatar, I can definitely reuse the code that I did earlier in my navigation bar. And if I scroll a little bit, I'm going to find the avatar. So I can just copy this code here, go back to match view, and paste that. Next, I'm just going to add a text on the right side. Let's write taught by Mangto or whatever text you want to put. We're going to set the font to footnote. We can even add a divider, which is a built-in line that is one point, which is not going to double in size or triple in size depending on the density of the screen. So it's this line right here, and that's all the code that you need. So look at this, it's pretty awesome. And we can just change back the order of the text because at this point we can just follow the design and we don't need to demonstrate anymore the power of mesh geometry. So in the next session, I want to show you how to create views out of this demo match view, because we don't necessarily want to use the main card in its own view. We actually want to use it on the home view. And also we want to create a detail view for the end screen. So we need to separate that. We're going to need to synchronize the namespace between all of those views. Then we're going to solve more problems as we go. So I'll see you in the next video.